I sometimes feel that I am impersonating the dark subconscious of the whole human race.
I'm going to give the people what they want. Sensation, horror, shock. Send them out in the streets to tell their friends how wonderful it is to be scared to death. But I refuse to die until that happiness has been assured.
Greetings, gentlemen. It is I, Victor von Frankenstein, the grateful MGTOW. As promised, I am back with more content. Welcome. Let's get started. I started working on a project last night. I was planning on doing a segment about philosophy. I found a small compendium of philosophers from the past at a used bookstore years ago, and I wanted to do a video series of randomly picked segments to explore. Open the book and whatever philosopher popped up, make a video discussing their ideas and postulations, whether they are rational or not. Notice the keyword being, was. Funny that I opened the book last night to David Emil Durkheim. However, that video will have to wait for another day. Maybe it is the universal synchronicities or karma, but the absolute ridiculousness of online autism and retrogradation that I woke up to this morning needed to be addressed. Right at the top of my YouTube feed, there it was. It's almost 2019, please, just stop it already, get some help. Please, for the love of all the little puppies, these people need to stop getting paid to spread outright lies and disinformation. Enter, the Diet Coke, Trade Femme, Chameleon. Enjoy the clip and it'll catch you at the end.
Why would you advocate for MGTOW? I'm certainly not advocating for MGTOW. I was simply sharing information in a journalistic fashion. I don't know why anyone would assume that explaining MGTOW is advocating for MGTOW. I believed that a percentage of people in MGTOW were actually abuse survivors, people who have been abused by toxic women. That's a thing. And I thought if those people found this video and they wanted help, maybe I could help them.
It is so easy to commit embarrassing blunders, but etiquette tells us just what is expected of us. And guards us from all humiliation and discomfort.
You're wrong. Women have never been oppressed in this country. Are you freaking kidding me? Really? Okay, let's talk about this, shall we? Women make up 51% of the population now, but yet they only make up 19% of Congress. Let's talk about a few other things. Women pay more for shampoo and other household items than men. Even socks and simple underwear that can't possibly cost more to make. Women on average make 16% less than their male counterparts, and this is even worse for women of color.
Fine mess you've made of things again.
So what does that mean exactly? Well, it means that in order for women to make the same amount of money as men on average, they would need to work an extra 40 days per year. And that's in the United States, where women are lucky enough to make 84%. Overseas, we're looking at something more like 77% of what their male counterparts make in their same careers. And once again, it's even worse for women of color. Women of color have to work 19 months to their male counterparts' 12 months to make the same amount of money. Seriously. Women are the minority in the executive suites. They are the minority in the media. Women are the minority in the tech sector. And they're still doing most of the housework, regardless of whether they work inside the home, outside the home, or not.
It is quite obvious that you do not understand me, and in all probability, you never will.
And let's get real. Women are more likely to be victims of human trafficking. Women and girls, females. In fact, of the 800,000 people who are trafficked every year, more than 80% of them are female.
Ah, but what an amontillado. A wine to conjure memories of taste buds in transport.
Women in the military face harassment, rape, sexual discrimination. As a matter of fact, up to half of all female military members are harassed sexually. A 2013 Pentagon report says that women are more likely to leave the military with CPTSD from extended periods of harassment or rape than fighting. In fact, women overall are at a greater risk for physical and domestic violence. As many as 70% of women experience this in their lifetime. And yes, I'm one of those people who experienced it. I want to note here that this happens to men too, but in much smaller percentages. It doesn't excuse it, but these are facts.
Good day to you, you penny-pinching old pig.
Women are more likely to live in poverty than men. I know you're going to tell me that that's because women don't work as much as men. That's not true. I just explained that to you. Again, I'm not saying all men are bad, and I'm not saying that men are not being oppressed. What I am saying is you cannot say that women have not been oppressed in this country or any other country.
Is there no morality left in this world?
Men are better at everything than women. Women are stupid, lazy, and useless. I gave birth to 3 babies and fed them all from my breasts. What did you do?
I soon uncovered a quantity of building stone and mortar. With these materials and with the aid of a trowel, I began vigorously to wall up.
I mean, come on. Men and women are not the same. They're different. I can't believe the amount of rage I saw in the comments about women needing to give up their rights. We just got rights a minute ago. Give us a minute. I do not believe women are more powerful in this society than men. I know that a lot of men do believe that, and I know that there are some men who have gotten screwed over by the court system.
Should I give him some medicine?
Can you do more research on MGTOW? Nope. Don't want to. Don't need to. You've told me I shouldn't even be talking about this, so not gonna do that. Thanks, though. Divorce always means the woman wins everything. That's not fair. Those of you who commented about men being less likely to file divorce were correct. However, when it comes to breaking up with somebody, that statistic is a little bit different. The reason that women file divorce more often is because, in many cases, men don't take action to do so, even if they're as miserable as the woman. But I know, you're going to tell me that's because they're afraid they'll lose everything, and there's a certain amount of truth to that for many people. And it's frustrating. I know it is. Every divorce situation is frustrating. There's just no right answer here. Divorce sucks. So my answer to that is try to be a little pickier about who we marry. I don't know if there's a better way to say that, but hey, MGTOW's got that covered because they're not getting married, so you're good, right? No, no more talking about MGTOW today, or ever. Men don't get to
Welcome back, gentlemen. I hope everyone enjoyed the ride. It is this type of gynocentric feminist propaganda being perpetuated every day that we as men must face. The entire video was typical shaming tactics, misinformation, and outright lies about men. And yet only defense of women or redirection of accountability responsibilities for the toxic female behavior that exists today. With over 62,000 followers and a YouTube join button, it is not difficult to see why women like this gain support on social media and are protected by Silicon Valley's corporate leftist agenda. Whereas, any man that chooses to stand up, to exercise his right to free speech, to fight back against the system of our enslavement will eventually be met with censure. I hope this finds you well, and there will be more to come in the future. As with any other channel, I'd like everyone to not like, don't subscribe, and stuff that bell up YouTube's ass. Thank you and fare thee well, gentlemen.
There was an old man from the Cape who made himself garments of crepe. When asked, will they tear, he replied, here and there, but they keep such a beautiful shape.